Hello, here at the Qt World Summit at the talk about virtual keyboards on embedded devices. My name is Jan-Arne Petersen. I work at KDAP, and I have already some years experience with the virtual keyboards. I worked on the virtual keyboard for the Nokia N9, so that's already quite some years ago, and was always involved also a little bit in this stuff during these years. So you have like more and more embedded devices, and you maybe need to enter some text in your device or some data. So when you look at your embedded device, you need to see what kind of data do you want to input at all. So is it just like some PIN code during the startup or some wireless password, or do you have also some simpler or more complicated input, or like you want to support a browser or third-party applications with full input or chatting or searching or something like this? And of course you have like other requirements in just entering your PIN code. Another question is of course, what kind of device do you have? What kind of screen do you have? I mean, okay, you need a touchscreen for a virtual device, but maybe it's like a really tiny one, or it's a bigger one, or you have an additional hardware buttons where you could do the input also, or you have some other kind of inputs like language or gestures or something like this. You need to look a little bit what kind of device you have, because like embedded devices are like, of course, all kind of different. You have like more this phone, tablet style things, but also or like infotainment in a car, but maybe also just like some box with little input or something like this. Yeah. So the next question is, the next thing is, how can Qt help you with using a virtual keyboard in your Qt application? There's like an input method API, which allows you to use a virtual keyboard from Qt side. It has like a application side that's called Qt input method, where you can access the virtual keyboard, you can show it, hide it. And so on. You have a Qt platform input context, which is on the platform side or virtual keyboard side. And then you have basically two kind of events, information sent from the application to the keyboard with Qt input method query event. And you have events sent from the virtual keyboard to your application via input method events or key events. There's also like a small diagram, so when you have like some line edit, then it uses a Qt input method API to show your keyboard, and then it sends information out via this Qt input method query events and get like the Qt input method events back. As I said, the Qt platform input context is part of this whole thing, so that's part of the Qt PA platform abstraction from Qt. There's basically two kinds. One is for the native platform plugins, for native virtual keyboards, like on Android, or you can have like custom ones via Qt platform input context factory. There are some platforms that's like from the dev branch. I checked that. If like on Android, iOS, QNX, Wayland, and Windows, you can basically use like the native virtual keyboard or virtual keyboard in or this native input system method system to. Or you can use custom ones, and some you can choose, like in Wayland or Windows, and in some you can just use the custom one. Yeah, for this kubeplatform input context factory, you can basically define some plugin via this environment variable, which creates then the right plugin, and there's like some different if you set it or not, you get like the default one or your chosen one. For Wayland, I got that question also like a couple days ago. There's since Qt 5.7, there's basically like there's a default plugin which basically which uses a Wayland text input protocol to forward all the Qt input method API on a client to the compositor. When you build a Qt Wayland compositor, you can just use this text input extension and basically have automatically support for virtual keyboards in your clients when you have like a virtual keyboard in your compositor. The protocol version which is used in Qt is currently not the same as upstream or in Western, so there's like a little bit confusion, but that should be soon, hopefully, both merge again in a new version. So then you can use Western or Qt Wayland compositors without problem. When you use, for example, the Qt virtual keyboard, you can just simply embed it in your QML application, runs in the same process. So you can just, when you, for example, have this input panel here from the virtual keyboard included in your Qt Wayland compositor and have this text input manager extension there enabled, then you just have basically your Qt Wayland compositor and virtual keyboard support for all your applications and your compositor. That's an example where we have the Qt virtual keyboard, and that's like a compositor, and here's like an application. Just basically use it. Since Qt 5.7, there's also the Qt virtual keyboard module is actually like older, but before Qt 5.7, it was just commercial. Since 5.7, it's commercial and GPL. You can either embed it as I just shown it, or on the X platform, it automatically displays in a separate window. And else, you have to embed it. It basically uses QML. It has some support for, I think, 60 or 70 language layouts. It also supports Chinese, Japanese, and Korean with some. Let's say like some simpler free engines. It doesn't really have prediction support for the languages. It has some kind of text correction via Handspell. And there's also some handwriting support using some free Lippy toolkit, which somehow like is, yeah, I would say more like a demo feature. You can just have to set this environment variable, and then you can get that. We were just working with the company MyScript together to add additional support for the MyScript engine into the Qt virtual keyboard. It's not included yet, but it should be included in Qt 5.11. And we partnered with MyScript and the Qt company to implement that. They have some advanced commercial engines. They have like a long history of experience in this field of input engines and handwriting, and especially in the automotive field. So they have already their system embedded in lots of cars. There you get like support for a lot of for handwriting with. You can just like use cursive writing. You can just write words on top of each other. You get transliteration. You get prediction and spelling correction all together. It supports all the languages in the Qt Virtual Keyboard. And I'm a quick demo, I think. See if I so. So I have it here installed. So yeah, I mean my handwriting and this touch screen is also not so perfect. I sometimes think it recognizes my handwriting better than I do it myself, but yeah, it also supports your different languages. So, well, we have like whatever. As you can see, you can just write on top of each other. Yeah, that's now German. Yeah. So, yeah, it works actually quite good. It hopefully comes like in Qt 5.11, the integration to the engine, and when you need some more advanced input, for example, on automotive or something like this, where you want to provide these features, you can probably talk to these guys. So we have this the input method API, which I was talking about, and I mean, having such a virtual keyboard has, of course, some like it's like a little bit different to like a hardware keyboard. It's sometimes a bit harder to type. I mean, you have like something like prediction for that, or like handwriting. But also there it helps when you can give some kind of purposes, for example, for your text field. I can also show that. So when you have like your, for example, a phone number field, and then it can recognize, then it sees directly that you want like numbers or something like this. So. So we have also support in Qt for that. It's basically called Qt QtIM hints or input method hints. There's like different stuff you can do. For example, say if it's like a password or like a number or like an email address or something like this, which of course helps you then, or helps the engine then to pick the right dictionary to do your prediction and to get better results there. And of course, when you do something like passwords or hidden text, then it doesn't save your stuff in your user dictionary or something like this, which you don't want to do. Yeah, when you use like QML, you can just basically set this input method hint property to one of these values or or it's basically like flags, and you can sometimes combine this, depending on that. You can also modify the behavior of the enter key to give some more feedback, what like happens when you press it. So you can like, for example, have a send button or like a search button, or a next button when you want to have multiple input fields on. in hopefully Qt 5.11, there's already also a patch pending. There would be also possible to set like a custom label or to enable and disable it. Depending on that's also supported for some of the native virtual keyboards, for example, for iOS or Android, and it's mapped to there. Yeah, in QML it's like easy again. You can just use this attached enter key type property to set it. And while you can set this input method hints, you can also easily set on the widgets with like Qt widget set input method hints. I don't think there's any API for enter keys, so they would need to handle this query event yourself. There's a last. What's also like interesting is what do you want to do with your user interface when your virtual keyboard shows up? So in the Q input methods, there's like some kind of methods like visible or keyboard rectangle with returns to if there's a virtual keyboard visible, where on the screen is it displayed, so that you can like change UI accordingly to not have your input fields basically covered by the text field, so that you cannot even see what is entered there. But that, of course, requires also sometimes some thinking how you do your UI layouting there. Are there any questions? Yeah?
Can you remove buttons or add your own buttons?
On the Qt virtual keyboard? You can change the Qt virtual keyboard itself when you like do that, but there's no like support from like application side or something like this to modify it. But of course, I mean, on an embedded device, you maybe know your use cases, so you can just modify your virtual keyboard, Qt virtual keyboard, the way you want it. But the layout files are basically also QML, so you can just change them. Yeah?
What would be the proper way to load our own layout in style? So we have like all the QMLs with the layout and our custom style, so what would be the proper way to load it into virtual keyboard?
Currently you basically, I think there's somewhere some directory where you can put it in. I think they currently compile it in the QRC as a resource, so you basically have to...
I just have to adjust the path.
Yeah, yeah.
And it will do it automatically.
So you have to, I'm not 100% sure how good that works. I need to look at that, yeah. Yeah. Yeah?
I'm very interested in sharing input method state between the physical keyboard input stack and the virtual keyboard. Do you think it's feasible to extend the virtual keyboard with the language set that wraps around IGOS or SVGX? So basically what we want to do, like when you compose character, you want to start with the physical keyboard and detach it and continue on the virtual keyboard. Like you need to reconvert it.
One can try some stuff there. It's like always this thing, how really usable that is then. I don't know, one can talk about that. I mean, if you have any other questions and so on, we are still here on the, you have the KDAP booth, and you can also try out this handwriting from the MyScript here on my notebook or up at the booth if you want to come over there. Okay. Okay, thanks for listening and